CHOP, COP, CCNU, single agent protocol, multi-agent protocol, just steroids. It is so confusing when you're trying to decide which chemotherapy protocol to give your cat with lymphoma. Welcome back to the vlog. This video is all about cats with lymphoma and chemotherapy protocols. Before we dive in and focus on the different chemotherapy protocols, I want to remind you, we just did some videos that go through all the basics about cats with lymphoma, specifically GI lymphoma, where I talk about high-grade, large cell lymphoma, and small cell low-grade lymphoma. So please go back and watch those videos. I also want to remind you of a couple of really important videos that you're going to need to know if you're thinking about giving your cat chemotherapy. Specifically, vlog number 93, which is all about chemotherapy side effects. Really important video. So we'll put the link below for that. And also my chemotherapy information sheets, which are the sheets that I give my clients when they come see me in my practice. So you can print those out from my website. Again, we'll put the link below. Also, if you are having a pet that's going through chemotherapy, you should definitely watch my chemotherapy safety video. So this is all about home safety if you have a pet going through chemotherapy in your home. It is definitely safe to have a pet that is receiving chemotherapy in your home with your family member, with your children, with other pets, but there are some common sense precautions that you should know about, and we highlight that in the video. So again, we'll put all the links below so you can easily find those videos. So I'm going to break this down into four overall categories of different chemotherapy options. And these are first line options. Well, actually they're going to be three options and then no therapy, because that is what some people choose and that's okay. I just want you to have all the options laid out for you. Okay, so the first option is going to be a combination chemotherapy protocol. And there's more than one combination chemotherapy protocol, but overall, that this is going to give you the highest possibility of a complete remission rate. And as we went through in the last set of videos, and this is true for dogs and cats with lymphoma, a complete remission is so important. So the lymphoma being undetectable. So for cats, remember their lymphoma tends to be internal and gastrointestinal of the GI tract, of the lymph nodes in the abdomen is going to be the most common form. So those lymph nodes, that GI mass resolves, and usually, as I talked about in the last video, when we do a follow-up ultrasound, we can't detect that lymphoma anymore. So to get the highest possibility or the highest likelihood of a complete response rate, that's going to be a combination chemotherapy where you're giving different drugs that each have a different mechanism of action against the lymphoma. And usually we cycle through the different drugs. So overall, when you look at the different combination chemotherapy protocols, we see about a 50 to 80% complete response rate. And in general, most cats are going to be in remission for about 5 to 9 months. As I talked about in the last video, cats are less predictable than dogs. So there's a subset of kitties that don't respond that unfortunately will have shorter overall remissions and shorter survival times. But again, those cats that go into complete remission tend to be our cats that have longer survival times and usually a median survival time of about 1 year. So again, about 50% of those cats are alive out 1 year. There's a few combination chemotherapy protocols out there, and there's a couple of variations of how often you'll come in and how long the different protocols are. My personal preference is the University of Wisconsin CHOP chemotherapy protocol, and it's a 25-week protocol. Again, there are other different protocols out there, so when you meet with your oncologist, and again, we'll put a link on where you can find a vet specialist or an oncologist in your area, hopefully. So talk to your veterinarian, talk to your specialist about the combination chemotherapy protocol that they recommend. But again, I use the University of Wisconsin 25-week CHOP chemotherapy protocol. I know that's a lot of words. So again, the CHOP is an acronym and it stands for the different drugs in the protocol. The C is cyclophosphamide. The H is actually the chemical or the name for doxorubicin or adriamycin. The O is vincristine, which is Oncovin. Again, the trade name for that. And the P is the steroid prednisolone is what I recommend. Overall, again, we see about 40 to 70% complete remission rates for this protocol, and median remission rates are about 7 to 9 months. Again, the cats that go into a complete remission are going to do better. The cats that have those complete remission rates, usually we have a median survival time of about 1 year. This protocol can be used for cats with other anatomic forms of lymphoma. So if your cat has nasal lymphoma, renal lymphoma, spinal lymphoma, liver lymphoma, so it's not just recommended. So any of the high-grade lymphomas will be using this protocol. Again, it is very well tolerated, and if you watch some of my other videos, my other cat lymphoma videos and the chemotherapy side effect videos, I definitely want to remind you that chemotherapy is better well tolerated in cats than dogs, and dogs and cats as a group tolerate chemotherapy better than people alone. So definitely check out vlog number 93 where I talk about that in detail. I do want to just comment, there are some recent studies looking at shorter versions of the CHOP protocols, and there are still some studies where there's maintenance phases where it will go beyond the 6 month protocol. I personally, and most studies, do not support using that maintenance phase. That would be where they come in like every 3 weeks after the protocol to get routine chemotherapy. Again, the shorter protocols are trying to see if we give less chemo, will they do just as well? So the jury is still out on that. There'll be continue to see some studies. Again, what continues to show in study after study is, again, those cats that go into complete remission tend to do better. So that's going to be really important. And if your cat's not going into complete remission, just as in dogs, we recommend switching the protocol to something else. Another combination chemotherapy protocol that is pretty well known and commonly used is the COP chemotherapy protocol. This one does not have the H in it, so it does not have doxorubicin. There are some studies that show that doxorubicin is really essential for that durable remission, so to keep your cat in remission. Another big difference with the COP chemotherapy protocol, it's only weekly for a month, then it's every 3 weeks, but it's a maintenance protocol and it keeps going for about a year. The CHOP protocol is 6 months and then you're done. So it's weekly for about the first 2.5 months and then every other week for 6 months and then you're done. So again, my preference is the CHOP 6 month protocol, but the COP would be an alternative protocol. Again, you want to talk to your specialist about what they recommend for your cat, but again, the CHOP multi-agent chemotherapy protocol is my multi-agent chemotherapy protocol of choice. Okay, category number 2 is going to be a single agent protocol. And if you watch my dog video, and hopefully you haven't had to deal with this in a dog and a cat, but that usually becomes a more economical option because you're not coming in quite as often and you're giving one drug as opposed to multiple drugs very frequently. So the next best option after a combination chemotherapy protocol in cats, and this is different than in dogs, is going to be single agent oral lomustine. In the intro, I referred to this as CCNU, which is an abbreviation of its chemical name. And this is based on a study that was done by Dr. Rao in 2017. And so this is an oral pill. In my practice, you would come in, I would examine your kitty, we would run a CBC and a chemistry panel to check the liver values because this can be affect the liver. After we check the white blood cell count and all of the blood work, including the liver values, in my practice, we usually administer the pills for the owner there and then you go home. The nice thing about this protocol is it's given usually monthly every 4 to 6 weeks. So you're not going in that often, not weekly to every other week like you are with the combination chemotherapy protocols. So an advantage is it's a lot less expensive. The practice doesn't have to deal with all the chemotherapy safety that we have to deal with the hood. If you've watched any of my other videos, you see that we gown up, we make chemotherapy up in a hood. You know, we have to use a closed system to keep everything safe. So it's much more practical to be giving oral chemotherapy in a practice. But how does it work, Dr. Sue? Well, that's a great question. So it's not as effective, but it's very reasonable. It has reasonable cost. We give it with steroids to cats. It seems to be well tolerated and effective. Not as effective as the multi-agent combination chemotherapy protocols, but again, it does seem to be a reasonable option. Let's break it down. So in the study, half of the cats got low white blood cell counts, but none of those cats were hospitalized or got septic from the low white blood cell count. In this study that I quoted, only 22% of cats had a complete remission. So that's pretty low. About 30% of the cats had a partial response. But the median duration of response was about 10 months, and it ranged from 2 months to 4 years. So that's pretty respectable. The median survival time of the cats in this study was 3.5 months, but it ranged from 4 days to a little bit over 4 years. So there's definitely a range that we were seeing in this. So it was very well tolerated. It seemed to be effective. It definitely is going to be significantly less expensive. You're going to be visiting the veterinarian less often than these multi-agent chemotherapy protocols, and it's much easier to administer than the injectable chemotherapy protocols. So it's a good plan B if the cost and the frequent visits of a multi-agent combination chemotherapy protocol are, you know, not, you know, in the cards for you. So I think it's a really good option to know about. Again, much shorter median survival time for this, but again, there were some cats that had really good quality of life on the protocol, and you know that, you know, with a median duration of response of about 10 months, and there was a good range on that. So something to consider, in my opinion. What's the best? Combination chemotherapy, but I think this would be a good plan B. I do want to mention there are some other single agent chemotherapy protocols that we use in dogs that are not as effective in cats. So single agent doxorubicin, which I told you is in the combination chemotherapy protocol, and really seems to make a difference in the difference between COP and CHOP, not as a good choice as a single agent protocol in cats. So I really like single agent doxorubicin if a family doesn't want to do a multi-agent protocol in dogs. Not a good choice in cats. It's just really not effective. I'm going to go to lomustine in cats if the family does not want to do a multi-agent chemotherapy protocol. Tanovia, which is a brand new drug that we have for dogs that was just approved about a year and a half ago, is not labeled for cats, so we're not using that in cats. Not, you know, not an option at this point. So again, lomustine would be another good option. There are some other protocols. There's the MOP multi-agent protocol and a couple other variations. But again, I'm just trying to break it down for you some of the basic protocols that I would recommend as first line options. The third category that I'm going to recommend is steroids. So if you decide that chemotherapy is not the option for you, whether it's cost, you know, having to go to the vet frequently or an oncologist frequently, I would definitely talk to your veterinarian, to the oncologist, about the addition of steroids. I recommend prednisolone in cats over prednisone. So it's estimated about half of cats don't have the enzyme to convert prednisone to the active form, which is prednisolone. That's why I recommend prednisolone. I have two vlogs that review steroids and their different uses, and so you can check those out. They're vlog number 79 and 80, and we will put links below. But steroids, you know, we're not just putting them on just to as an anti-inflammatory, which they are, but they actually have an anti-lymphoma property. So they do kill the lymphoma cells. And so if you decide against chemotherapy, I recommend, if there's no other reason that your cat shouldn't be on steroids, that your cat start prednisolone. And that is definitely something that you should talk to your veterinarian about going home with at that appointment. Unlike dogs, it does not seem to increase resistance. So you can start steroids while you're thinking about starting chemotherapy. Very different than dogs. So again, and I talk about that in the two steroid videos, 79 and 80, so you can check those out. So what it does to the survival time, so usually cats with no therapy for high-grade lymphoma, it's about a month, and steroids can increase that to about 2 to 3 months. Remember, anytime I give you numbers, there will be ranges on both sides of that, and I always hope that I'm wrong and that your kitty is living longer than the statistics predict. And finally, the fourth option is no therapy at all. And that is always an option. In my opinion, for lymphoma in dogs and cats, if you're not going to treat, and there's no reason not to put your pet on steroids, so talk it over with your veterinarian. You know, I can't be your veterinarian through YouTube. please talk to them about, you know, going home on steroids. Again, I recommend prednisolone in cats because not only can it kill those cancer cells, but it is palliative. It does make them feel better. Usually we see about a 50% response rate in some cats, depending on what their response rate would be. So I think it is really a good option. But again, you're not obligated to do anything, and that is always an option to do no treatment. I didn't forget about those kitties with low-grade small cell lymphoma. Those kitties are usually treated differently than cats with high-grade lymphoma. Those kitties are usually treated with a combination of steroids, the prednisolone, with an oral chemotherapy called Leucovorin or Chlorambucil, which is treated as a chronic, and it's treated chronically. There are always going to be exceptions to the rule, and so that's why I think it's great to talk to a medical oncologist like myself. I do have some cats that come in quite sick, very cachectic. They've lost a lot of muscle, a lot of body mass. There are some cats that I will start with some injectable chemotherapy just to kind of get the cancer a little bit under control more quickly, but then I will transition them over to the combination of steroids with chlorambucil. But just to recap, in general, the therapy for small cell low-grade lymphoma is going to be steroids with Leucovorin chlorambucil, which is an oral chemotherapy drug that you are going to be administering at home under the care of your veterinary oncologist, your veterinarian. That does require routine blood work. Usually, for me, I recommend every 2 weeks for about 2 to 3 visits, so usually about 6 weeks, and then we go to monthly appointments and then every 6 week appointments. Why? We're monitoring weight, we're monitoring for side effects, but we do need to monitor for low white blood cell counts, low platelets, and liver issues. Those are some of the side effects that we can see with chronic chlorambucils. But overall, and I talk about this in the last video where we talk about the prognosis tends to be better for those cats with small cell chronic lymphoma. And that wraps up my video on the different chemotherapy protocols for cats with lymphoma. Thank you so much for watching. You know what I'm gonna ask you to do? Please subscribe, please comment. Let me know if you have any additional questions, what other protocols you wanna know about. Share it, tell me about the experience that your cat had going through chemotherapy. And I really wanna hear back from you. I so appreciate you taking the time to watch. Let me know what other videos you want to see, and hopefully I will see you at the next video.